What is going good, people? James back here with a bonus episode of From the Vault, and good news, you're getting two of these this week. So, don't forget to like this episode, go back, watch, and like all my other episodes. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel. Also, click that notification bell so you can be notified of all my new episodes. Like me on Facebook, follow me on Twitter. Links to those are in the comments section below, and thanks to those who have already done so. And yeah, you did hear that right. You're getting two bonus episodes this week. You have this one here, then you're going to have the counter part to this one, and I'll explain that in a little bit. And then next week is going to be episode 36, Shawn Michaels' Survivor Series Legacy. The final week of November is going to be episode 37, The Undertaker's Survivor Series Legacy. Now, what about the week of Thanksgiving? Well, I have a poll out for that one, and since it's the week of Thanksgiving, I'm going to be covering a Survivor Series that took place on Thanksgiving, which that means it only gives you four choices. So, the first choice, Survivor Series 1987. The second choice, Survivor Series 1988. The third choice, Survivor Series 1989. And the fourth choice, Survivor Series 1990. So click the Twitter link to the poll and vote on the poll. Survivor Series 87, 88, 89, or 90. Now to this episode, the first of two bonus episodes for this week. And these two bonus episodes are the yin and the yang of each other, because if you've been following these episodes, and if you haven't, what are you waiting for? Go back and watch all my other episodes now. With the pay-per-view episodes, when I go through and talk about the pay-per-views and give my thoughts on the pay-per-views, with the pay-per-view episodes, I'm giving the golden ring bell and the brown ring bell to the best and the worst match for whatever show I'm talking about. Now, for these two episodes for this week, one of the episodes is going to be the golden ring bells, one of the episodes is going to be the brown ring bell, so stay tuned later on this week for the brown ring bell episode. This episode is From the Vault, Survivor Series Golden Ring Bells. To start off Golden Ring Bells, you might as well start at the beginning, and the beginning is Survivor Series 1987. And the Golden Ring Bell for Survivor Series 1987 is actually kind of difficult, because every single match on that show was a really good match. However, in my opinion, Golden Ring Bell for Survivor Series 1987 goes to Team Hogan versus Team Andre. Again, in a show of really good matches, this match stood out from all the others. You had great storytelling, great advancing of the Hogan-Andre angle, and Andre is the sole survivor. It was needed to do the title rematch in February with all the other added story to that feud. Overall, a great main event and deserving of Golden Ring Bell. Survivor Series 1988, Golden Ring Bell for that show goes to Team Powers of Pain versus Team Demolition. Yeah, at 42 minutes, this match is one of the longer ones on here, but in a match with 10 tag teams totaling 20 wrestlers, of course it's going to be a long match. Two great stories were told during this match. One, the start of the Rockers Brainbusters feud that would go on throughout 1989, and the other was WWF's first double turn, when Mr. Fuji turned on Demolition to join the Powers of Pain, and in the process, turning Demolition babyface and the Powers of Pain heel. Although if you listen to the crowd, they were cheering Powers of Pain because they thought that, hey, wait, Fuji's joining them, so he must be good. But it was 1988, didn't really know much of that stuff back then. Well, you know. So, great match overall, deserving of Golden Ring Bell. Survivor Series 1989. Golden Ring Bell for that show goes to the Ultimate Warriors versus the Heenan family. Yeah, it was a main event without Hulk Hogan, and back in those days it was shocking. But this match here, it was the litmus test to see if the Ultimate Warrior was truly the next top star, and to see, hey, are we going to main event him with Hulk Hogan at WrestleMania 6? And Warrior passed with flying colors in this match. Bobby Heenan replaced Tully Blanchard in this match, and hey, Bobby Heenan pinned Marty Jannetty, so there you go there. But in the end, though, Bobby Heenan got his Ultimate Warrior was sole survivor, Golden Ring Bell for Survivor Series 1989. Survivor Series 1990, the Golden Ring Bell for that show goes to the Dream Team versus the Million Dollar Team. Now, this match is most notably remembered for being the debut of The Undertaker. This match, however, has more to it than just that. This was also the match Bret Hart dedicated to his brother Dean, who passed away the day prior. This match was a really good match that not only established The Undertaker as a future force in the WWF, but this match also showed people that, hey, Bret Hart was more than just a tag team wrestler, and Bret also said motherfucker at the end of the match. So there's that. Survivor Series 1991. Golden Ring Bell for that show goes to Team Flair versus Team Piper in the opener. That match was literally the only good match on Survivor Series 1991. I mean, and it's really not saying that much. And yeah, it was a good match. However, at the pace it was going, it was going to be an hour-long match. I mean, it was 22 minutes in. There was only two eliminations. Time for the finish. And it was one of the worst finishes to any Survivor Series match ever, as everyone but Ric Flair got disqualified for brawling, and therefore, Ric Flair was the sole survivor. And other than that, yeah, this was the best match of one of the worst Survivor Series events of all time. Survivor Series 1992. Golden Ring Bell for that show goes to Bret Hart versus Shawn Michaels for the World Wrestling Federation Championship. The first time that a WWF Championship match main evented a Survivor Series, and it was a damn good match. This match is often forgotten due to the Iron Man match and Montreal, and yeah, this one here, it was a great match, too. I wish people would remember it more often, because, again, people remember the Iron Man match, people remember Montreal, people don't really remember this one, but Bret Hart, Shawn Michaels tore the house down, and it's weird to think that this match was originally just supposed to be a normal one-on-one match in the mid-card. But it took a few things, and this turned into a WWF Championship match, and when you really think about it, it was champion versus champion, because Shawn Michaels was the Intercontinental Champion as well. That title was not on the line. Survivor Series 1993. Golden Ring Bell for that show goes to the Heavenly Bodies versus the Rock and Roll Express for the Smoky Mountain Wrestling Tag Team Championships. Yeah, is it really, really, really sad that the best match of this show is a match that was for another company's championship? Yeah, I mean, this match was really the only good thing about this show. And granted, had this match happened, well, had it taken place, yeah, if this match took place below the Mason-Dixon line, the crowd would have been really into this match. Unfortunately, it took place in Boston, where no one knew either team. I mean, Rock and Roll Express never were in the WWF prior, and while the Heavenly Bodies were a part of the WWF at some point, they were really just in one time for SummerSlam, and that was really it in terms of major appearances. So, the crowd really wasn't in it. But, I mean, outside of that, it was just a really good match and the best thing apart this show. It was just wrong venue. Survivor Series 1994, and Golden Ring Bell for that show, goes to Bret Hart versus Bob Backlund in a submission match for the World Wrestling Federation Championship. Now, this is a match where you really have to like technical wrestling to enjoy it. I mean, and even if you're not, I mean, this does have some good storytelling to it, so it's a match, really, if you like technical wrestling, you'll enjoy this match. If you like good storytelling, you'll like this match as well. You have a bitter ex-champion who's gone crazy against the man who vows to straitjacket him once and for all. Plus, you throw in Bret's brother in his opponent's corner, Davey in his own corner, the throw-in-the-towel stipulation. This makes for a classic bout between Bret and Backlund, not like their match at WrestleMania 11, which deserves every brown ring bell in the history of brown ring bells, but I'll talk about that if I ever do golden ring bell and brown ring bell for WrestleMania 11. Now, the last few minutes of this match is proof that Owen Hart could have made a Hollywood career, his second career, not just pro wrestling. He could have been a Hollywood actor because his acting at the end, the last few minutes of this match, Owen Hart's acting was worthy of all the awards out there. Plus, we have the story of Bob Backlund, who wins back the World Wrestling Federation Championship in the same way he lost it 11 years prior. Survivor Series 1995. Golden ring bell for that show goes to Diesel versus Bret Hart in a no disqualification match for the World Wrestling Federation Championship. This was the third bout between the two for the championship, and this one was really the best of the three. I mean, yes, the prior two were great matches, but the prior two matches ended without a true winner in each match. You had the first one ending in DQ, the other one ended in a draw. This match here, you were gonna get a true winner because there was a stipulation added to it. It was going to be no disqualification, no countout, and the match cannot conclude unless it's by pinfall or submission. Diesel had been World Wrestling Federation champion for close to a year. Bret feels like Diesel held on to his title for a year. And this match, again, the best match of the three up to this point between Bret and Diesel. And you saw a vicious side of Bret Hart that you never really saw often. You saw it at the Royal Rumble, but you saw a more vicious side here of Bret Hart. Bret was going to do anything possible to win back the title. He felt like he never really lost. And of course, this was the night that the true Big Daddy Cool came back. Survivor Series 1996. Golden ring bell for this show, Bret Hart versus Steve Austin in a number one contendership match. If you like Holyfield and Tyson, you're gonna love this. Those were the words of Jim Ross that was the description of this match, and really, there's no better way to describe this match than that. This had big fight feel written all over it. This was Steve Austin's biggest match of his career up to this point. This was Bret Hart's televised return match, and the winner of this match gets to face whoever wins the main event for the World Wrestling Federation Championship. Everyone praises the submission match at WrestleMania 13, deservingly so. However, this one deserves the same amount of praise because it's just as good, and maybe slightly worse. But still, it's an amazing match between these two, and the finish, it was basically identical to WrestleMania 8. Survivor Series 1997. Golden ring bell for this show, and there's really no other option. Golden ring bell goes to Bret Hart versus Shawn Michaels for the World Wrestling Federation Championship. I mean, I really contemplated giving this match the golden ring bell due to, well, you know. However, and you look at this show, are there any other matches worthy of golden ring bell? Wait, there's not? Oh, that's what I thought. Now, while it's more memorable for the ending of the match, and we all know the ending to this one, however, you know, the match itself was actually a really good match. It's not as good as their 1992 match, it's not as good as their Iron Man match, but it's good enough to win Golden Ring Bell for this show, and really, you look at the rest of the matches at Survivor Series 1997, there's no surprise why this is Golden Ring Bell. Survivor Series 1998, the Deadly Games Tournament. Golden ring bell for this show, The Rock versus Mankind in the tournament finals to declare a new World Wrestling Federation champion. Survivor Series 1998 had a Survivor Series record 14 matches, 18 if you count Dark and Sunday Night Heat matches, which for these awards, I do not count those matches. Since there was a tournament to crown a new champion, similar to WrestleMania 4, most matches on this night had to be short, that way they stayed in their time allotment. The only match that could be given time was the only match that should have been given time, that was the finals, and it was a damn good finals match. Rock and Mankind had some amazing matches during this late 1998, early 99 time period, and while this was probably the worst of their matches, by no means was this a bad match. It was a really good match, and the ending is one of the best of any on this list. Survivor Series 1999, from my neck of the woods, Joe Louis Arena, Detroit, Michigan. And golden ring bell for this show is China versus Chris Jericho for the WWF Intercontinental Championship. And this is really one of those cases of, by default, this was the best match. I mean, really, look at all the other matches on this card and try to tell me one that was better. The 1999 edition of Survivor Series, it was one of the not-so-good ones, but it did have a really good Intercontinental Championship match with China and Chris Jericho, so, well, there's that. Survivor Series 2000. Golden ring bell for that show goes to Steve Austin versus Triple H in a no disqualification match. Even with the non-finish that there was, this match was outstanding as advertised. Billed for 1 year after Triple H hired Rikishi to run down Steve Austin with a car, Austin came back. He wants revenge on Triple H, and he got his revenge in more ways than one. This was a hard-hitting brawl. The ending, yeah, that was the revenge, and it was smashing revenge, as Steve Austin used a forklift on Triple H's car, lifted the car, and dropped it to the ground below, and Triple H was done, and we would never see him again. And that worked for about a week, but, well, that's another story for another day. Survivor Series 2001. While this is the epitome of everything wrong with the invasion, I really have no choice. Golden ring bell for this show goes to Team WWF versus Team Alliance, because can you really name a match better on this Survivor Series than this? So yeah, you had Team WWF Faces versus Team WWF Heels with a WCW and ECW guy in the main event. And yeah, again, it's the epitome of everything wrong with the invasion, but it is one of the best traditional Survivor Series matches of all time. And yeah, the end of WWF versus WCW comes down to Austin versus Rock, because why wouldn't it? However, it was a really good match and deserving of Golden Ring Bell, even though everything involved with it and the story was bad, the match ended up really good. Survivor Series 2002. Golden Ring Bell for this show goes to Triple H versus Shawn Michaels versus Chris Jericho versus Rob Van Dam versus Booker T versus Kane in an Elimination Chamber match for the World Heavyweight Championship. The first ever Elimination Chamber match, and yeah, we had no idea how this one was gonna go, but similar to the first Hell in a Cell match, the first Elimination Chamber match set the bar so high that all these years later, no other chamber match has ever or will ever hit the mark. And can we just say that Triple H is one tough SOB? In 1998, he wrestled a ladder match on essentially one leg. In 2001, he finished a match on a torn quad. Fast forward to 2007, where he did the same thing, but with the other quad. Fast forward to 2010, where he finished a match with a torn bicep, and then you fast forward to 2018, where he finished a match with a torn pec. Now rewind to 2002, he finished the first Elimination Chamber match with a crushed throat. To Hunter, I salute you. But this match, I mean, this match was really all about the comeback of Shawn Michaels, as well as redemption for Shawn Michaels, and it's never really mentioned, but you look at this, it was 6 years earlier at the same event in the same building, Shawn Michaels was booed out of Madison Square Garden in the main event. You fast forward 6 years later, he's getting a hero's reaction, and in the process, he wins the World Heavyweight Championship. Survivor Series 2003. Golden ring bell for this show goes to Team Austin versus Team Bischoff. This one, I've talked about it before, I'll talk about it again. This is one of my personal favorite traditional Survivor Series matches that's ever taken place. This has everything you want in one of these traditional matches. High stakes, high rewards. Austin's team wins, we get the old Stone Cold back. Austin's team loses, Austin must retire for good. The story of Shawn Michaels, down 3-1, bloody and battered, he fights back to 1-on-1, only to lose, but by nefarious means. I mean, if there's only one match you see from this show, this match is it. Survivor Series 2004, Golden Ring Bell here, goes to Shelton Benjamin versus Christian for the WWE Intercontinental Championship. Like a few other shows, this is a case of best by default, even though the main event was really good too, and you can make an argument. However, Shelton versus Christian for the Intercontinental title, yeah, it was a case of two good wrestlers going out there, having a really good match for a championship. A case of, well, nothing more, nothing less. And at the end of the day, you can't ask for more than that. Survivor Series 2005. Golden Ring Bell for this show goes to Triple H versus Ric Flair in a last man standing match. A show like a few of these shows. This was a show that was full of really good matches, like straight up and down the card, minus one or two. This match here, though, this stands above all the others. Holy shit. This match was amazing. One of the best non-traditional Survivor Series matches in the show's history. And hell, this match is proof that even in 2005, Ric Flair could still go out there and have amazing matches. If you have the right place, right setting, right opponent, maybe some smoke and mirrors, Ric Flair was still able to have amazing matches. And the visual of the end, Triple H over Ric Flair with the sledgehammer, the old taking the horse behind the barn, it was amazing. It was one of those matches. You know, this show overall, amazing Survivor Series, but if there's one match you have to see, it's Triple H Ric Flair in the Last Man Standing match. Survivor Series 2006. Golden Ring Bell for this show goes to Chris Benoit versus Chavo Guerrero for the WWE United States Championship. Yeah, overall, this Survivor Series sucked, and again, it's one of those by default sort of things. I mean, yeah, it was a good match, but it was nothing really special. I mean, on this show, it stands out as something really good, but overall, it was really just there. On this show, it was the best match. You put this on any other Survivor Series, and it would just be just another match. Survivor Series 2007. Golden Ring Bell for this show goes to Randy Orton versus Shawn Michaels for the WWE Championship. This match here is one of my 10 favorite matches in Survivor Series history. Outstanding match. The story of this, it was great. If Shawn Michaels used Sweet Chin Music, he would not only be disqualified, but he would never get another shot at the WWE Championship. However, if Randy Orton got disqualified, he would lose the WWE Championship. So these two were forced to tell a story in which Shawn couldn't use his finisher, and Orton had to not be chicken shit. It was fantastic, and even though you knew Shawn wasn't going to win the title here, you always had that hope, like, oh my god, he's actually going to win. Can he win? Holy shit, he's going to win, but he didn't. Just a great match with these two, and really, when you look at all the matches these two had over the years, this match here at Survivor Series 2007 was the best match between these two. Survivor Series 2008. Golden Ring Bell for this show goes to Team Orton versus Team Batista. Say it with me, people. By default. The 2008 edition of Survivor Series, it was not that good of one. And there was really only one good match within all the bad stuff, and yeah, this was it. It was a really good Survivor Series match. Nothing more, nothing less, just a good traditional Survivor Series match between Team Orton and Team Batista. Survivor Series 2009. Golden Ring Bell for this show goes to John Cena versus Triple H versus Shawn Michaels in a triple threat match for the WWE Championship. Now, I look back on this show, Survivor Series 2009, I was like, oh my god, this was a really good Survivor Series. I mean, it's forgotten about due to the time period, but in terms of 2009 shows go, this was one of the better 2009 shows, and overall, a really good Survivor Series. The main event, a really good triple threat match for the WWE Championship. Like most of his time at the top, the guy who never lost was the underdog, this time against DX. But as the bell rang, Shawn gave Triple H sweet chin music, meaning, yeah, we're a team, but, you know, at the end of the day, only one of us can be WWE champion. The two did work together somewhat during the match, but in the end, like Hogan in the 80s, when it came to the aughts, Cena must pose. Survivor Series 2010. Golden ring bell for this show goes to Daniel Bryan versus Ted DiBiase for the WWE United States Championship. And yeah, this show, the 2010 edition of Survivor Series was really a tale of two halves. You had the first half of the show that was really, really good, and then the second half of the show left a lot to be desired. But you look at the first half, it was a really good half, with Bryan versus DiBiase as the best of the bunch. And it was just two good wrestlers having a good match for a championship. Nothing more, nothing less. Survivor Series 2011. Golden ring bell for this show goes to Alberto Del Rio versus CM Punk for the WWE Championship. Now, the 2011 edition in Madison Square Garden is one of the more underrated Survivor Series in history, as really, you look up and down the show, there really wasn't anything too terrible on this show. And also, what was underrated was Alberto Del Rio's first run with the company. Yeah, over the last few years, we found out that Alberto is a major tool bag, but take away him being a tool bag, Alberto was a really good performer. And this match between him and Punk for the WWE Championship, it was an excellent match. And it began the 434-day reign for CM Punk, a reign that will probably be ended by AJ Styles this coming January. Not, you know, you get where I'm coming from. The record will be, well, the quote record will be broken. It will be AJ Styles over 434 days. You get where I'm coming from. Anyway, now, Survivor Series 2012. Golden ring bell for this show goes to Team Ziggler versus Team Foley. So this is a match that was supposed to be Team Punk versus Team Foley, with all the members of each team having something to do with each other from the pay-per-view prior. However, they changed things because, yeah, we need a WWE Championship match on the card. So what we got instead was Team Ziggler versus Team Foley, and yeah, it was a really good traditional Survivor Series match, and, you know, it's 6 years later, Dolph Ziggler is in the same spot he's been in all this time. Hell, he's been the Dolph Ziggler character for a decade, and he's been in the same exact spot. You know, maybe it's him, maybe it's creative, and maybe it's both. Survivor Series 2013. Golden ring bell for this show goes to CM Punk and Daniel Bryan versus the Wyatt family. A match that, you know, no one really asked for or really wanted, at least in this iteration. Remember the 12-man tag from Raw Country? Yeah, that 12-man tag should have been the Survivor Series match, where you have Punk and Bryan leading one team, and then the Shield and the Wyatts on the other team. But what we got instead was CM Punk and Daniel Bryan versus the Wyatt family in a tag match. Alas, it really was a good tag team match. Again, it's not what we really wanted, but it turned out to be really good. This was before the Wyatts were completely ruined, and before CM Punk was gone. And also before that weird time period where Daniel Bryan was a member of the Wyatt family. Regardless, a good tag match here on a show that really needed something good, because, yeah, I'll talk about it when I talk about Brown Ring Bell. Survivor Series 2014. Golden ring bell for this show goes to Team Cena versus Team Authority in a really good main event that really meant nothing because they retconned the whole thing a month later. But still, a really, really good main event, and honestly, one of the better main events in Survivor Series history. Yeah, you had so many member swaps during the build of this match, you thought this was the 1993 Survivor Series, but we ended up what we ended up with, and it was a really, really good match. You had a lot of good things in this, one of them being the 3-on-1 deficit where Dolph Ziggler overcame the odds, and the second thing, Sting's WWE debut. That's right, after 13 and a half years of wondering if Sting was coming to the company. Is he coming to WWE? When's he coming to WWE? And is he ever going to come to the WWE? We finally got our answer here on this show. Sting made his debut in the WWE, helped Cena's team defeat the Authority, Dolph Ziggler won a main event, and yeah, afterwards they had nothing for him, because again, decade as the Dolph Ziggler character, and he's in the same spot he's been in this entire time. So yeah, a really good match, but the results meant diddly shit, because again, they retconned the whole thing a month later. Survivor Series 2015. Golden ring bell for this show goes to Dean Ambrose versus Kevin Owens in a tournament semifinal. In the wake of Seth Rollins being forced to vacate the WWE World Heavyweight Championship due to injury, a tournament was held to crown a new champion, but only the semifinals and finals were aired on pay-per-view, which was both a good and bad thing. Good in the fact that we didn't have to sit through so many damn tournament matches in one night, but bad as we only get to saw three of them on pay-per-view, the rest were on Raw. Now, why not do the quarters, semis, and finals all in the show, with the Undertaker, Kane, Wyatt family stuff as the special attraction? Because really, the tournament and that stuff is all that mattered on this show, so why not do quarters, semis, finals, and the special attraction stuff? Anyways, Dean Ambrose, Kevin Owens, it was the best match of the three tournament matches, the best match on this show, therefore, golden ring bell for this show. Survivor Series 2016. Golden ring bell for this show goes to Team Raw versus Team SmackDown, Team AJ Styles versus Team Kevin Owens. 2016, it was the restart of the brand split, and in smart fashion, they decided to do Raw versus SmackDown for Survivor Series. Now, some may complain that, oh, it's just bragging rights, it's ruining the tradition of the Survivor Series. For the record, WWE ruined that tradition a whole hell of a long time ago. Also, isn't Survivor Series all about teams and surviving, so wouldn't Raw versus SmackDown work great with that concept? So yeah, you had the two world champions as captains, so it played into everything great. Great stories told here. You saw a Shield reunion tease, even though it was never really mentioned again. James Ellsworth got his revenge on Braun Strowman and then got destroyed for his troubles. Shane McMahon got speared into oblivion. But in the end, Randy Orton and, of all people, Bray Wyatt were the survivors in this, and this would all eventually lead to their horrible WrestleMania match as well as their infamous House of Horrors match in 2017. And speaking of 2017, we're at the end. Survivor Series 2017, golden ring bell for this show goes to AJ Styles versus Brock Lesnar in a champion versus champion match. 2017, they changed things up a bit with this Raw versus SmackDown brand supremacy thing for Survivor Series, where instead of the year before, they would just have the champions in Survivor Series matches. They were just having the champions face each other in regular matches. So you had world versus world, tag versus tag, women's versus women's, IC versus US. Now for world versus world, there's a bit of a changeup because originally this match was supposed to be Brock Lesnar versus Jinder Mahal. But on the November 7th episode of SmackDown, AJ Styles defeated Jinder Mahal to win the WWE Championship, and as of this recording, he is still the WWE Champion. Now, this match is a match where we're like, oh, there's no way this match is ever gonna happen, but it did. And it really was, well, Have you seen Brock's matches lately? He's not even trying, so how good's this match gonna be? But in the end, safe to say, this was Brock's best match since 2013. He and AJ put on a great match here. And also at the time of this recording, this is scheduled to happen this year. Survivor Series 2018. AJ Styles WWE Champion, Brock Lesnar Universal Champion, Champion versus Champion Part 2. Will Lightning strike twice and we get another amazing match with these two? Only time will tell. So, share your thoughts on the golden ring bells given for Survivor Series 1987 through 2017. What matches do you think were the best match at each Survivor Series? Any match that I mentioned that you disagree with? Say so in the comments section below. Don't forget to vote on the poll for Thanksgiving week. Again, Survivor Series 87, 88, 89, or 90. Vote on which Survivor Series you want me to cover on Thanksgiving week. And remember, stay tuned because later in the week, it's going to be time for some brown ring bells. Until next time, peace.